Has become a problem in your colony. I hope you'll resolve the situation swiftly. I'm informed that your colony is undergoing a hydration crisis. I trust you'll secure additional water supplies post-haste.
We can offer you a reward if you earn a few...
informs me that some of your colonists have become infected with microbes from plague spores. I trust you'll provide adequate health care to ensure the epidemic does not spread any further. have some thoughts on how to best expand your colony. We have some thoughts on how to best expand.
Here's your next population growth target.
Jeff, looks like somebody needs our help. You better get out there.
Thank you.
Looks like somebody needs our help. You better get out there. This looks like a guardian robot left over from the species that used to live here. It's guarding something, but I don't think it's gonna go peacefully.
Vori, you there?
Yeah, I'm here, Jack. What you got for me?
Hold on. Let me loop in the team. You're not gonna believe this. Kalandra, you on?
I'm here, Jack.
Euros.
I am here as well.
Good. I've looped in the High Commander as well. So I've decoded the fourth chapter. Remember that alien race that sent the warning to the shapeshifter people that they were all gonna die?
The Builders.
Right. Get this. A couple of weeks before the supposed supernova, they showed up in their mothership. And they said the whole thing about the extinction event was all just a big put-on.
You've got to be kidding me.
Seriously? So all of that, and there was no supernova after all?
Oh, hey, guess what, everybody? It was all a big joke. It was all a big joke.
Sorry about those millions of people who died in your civil war.
What a crock of
Yeah. So it turns out, that's like an interstellar initiation ritual for advanced civilizations. It's like a test. See, once a civilization gets advanced enough that it might finally be worthy of joining the club, so to speak, they tell them they're all gonna die and they have to fit their final words into a paperback novel. And that process is really ugly and starts a lot of wars. But it forces them to figure out who they are as a society. It makes them come together and figure out what's important and what's not. Sort of the way before we got on the Avon Prime expedition. We had to get all our luggage under 38 kilograms. And a lot of species don't make it.
Unbelievable.
They must have been pissed.
They were probably happy. I mean, they just found out they actually weren't going to die a horrible death. And you're not going to argue with some big alien mothership floating overhead anyway.
Good point.
So, what happened after that? Or do we have to wait another chapter to find out?
Sounds like they left the planet. Once the mothership showed up, they learned how to make ships of their own. And they didn't have that crazy death cult around to hold them back anymore.
So that explains that Setadari guy, and what it meant when they said they left him here until he could join them again.
So that means...
he might still be here.
Bingo!
Maybe, maybe not. I'm hoping we'll figure that out with Chapter 5.
Oh, great. So we might be sharing the planet with a crazy mass-murdering alien shapeshifter from an evil death cult. That just makes my day.
Makes you think, doesn't it? There's one more thing. There's another artifact in an area known as Eden Crater. I'm not sure what it is, but... it's clear that this is a more valuable object.
Does it have something to do with that Setadari character?
I don't think so.
Okay. We'll have the High Commander start a new colony in that location so we can... recover the object.
Eden Crater. Sounds peaceful.
No, it isn't. It's actually in one of the harshest locations on the surface. Get ready, High Commander. This is gonna be your toughest mission yet. Receiving reports that your colonists are complaining about inadequate water supplies. Hello, Your Excellency. You've been missed. Your colonists are eager to have you at the helm once again.